Let's start with the wave equation. Delta V minus 1 over C squared times the second time derivative of the pressure is equal to 0. In one dimension, the Laplace operator just boils down to the second derivative of pressure with respect to space. D'Alembert proposes a general solution in the form of the pressure signal at position x and at time t is the sum of two functions, f and g. F is a function of the combined variable t minus x over c, and g is a function of the combined variable t plus x over c. We denote u, the variable t minus x over c, and v is the combined variable t plus x over c, so that the pressure at position x and time t is the sum of f of u, u being a function of x and t, and g of v, v being a function of x and t. Let's verify that this is indeed a solution to the 1D wave equation. So we calculate the first derivative of f with respect to x, but f is a function of x via the function u, so that df over dx, partial f over partial x, is equal to df over du times the partial derivative of u with respect to x. This partial derivative of u with respect to x is minus 1 over r over c, so that we get that the partial derivative of f with respect to x is 1 over c times df over du. The second derivative of f with respect to x is going to give the same thing. It is the second derivative of f with respect to u times the derivative of u with respect to x, which gives us a 1 over c squared times d2f over du squared. For the time derivative, we have the same thing, except that the derivative of u with respect to time is equal to 1, so that the derivative of f with respect to time is simply the derivative of f with respect to u, and same for the second derivative of f with respect to t squared. It is just the second derivative of f with respect to u. So that if we combine these two second derivatives, the one with respect to x and the one with respect to t, we indeed see that the second derivative of f with respect to x minus 1 over c squared times the second derivative of f with respect to time is indeed equal to 0, whatever the function f, provided that f is sufficiently differentiable. And the same thing exactly holds for g.